Hi there, I'm Caroline from Doodles and Digits. Do you know what this is? Or this? Or these? These are fractions, and that's what we're gonna learn about today. Let's get into it.
Doodly doodle, doodly doodle, doodly doodles and digits. Area, symmetry, fractions too. It's all here for you.
Okay, so what is a fraction?
A fraction is a part of a whole.
There are actually two portions of a fraction. There's the numerator and also the denominator. In a fraction, the numerator and denominator tell us very important things.
All right, so what is a numerator and denominator? Let's look at a fraction right here. Before we start, here's a couple different representations of this fraction. What do you notice? What do you think the numerator is and the denominator is? All right, let's look at a model that matches this fraction. The numerator is the number of pieces that is actually represented or that we have. The denominator actually represents how many equal pieces are in a whole. Something to remember when we're talking about fractions is we are talking about equal parts. So the denominator is going to tell you how many equal parts we will have in the whole, and the numerator tells you how many equal parts you actually have. Here are multiple different representations of this fraction.
Where do we see fractions in everyday life?
Fractions are often used in measurements, when baking, when adding, subtracting. Sometimes when we're sharing, you'll think of fractions. For example, if we have a piece of pizza, we might be sharing the pizza. Or maybe you're talking about a pie and there's 12 slices in a pie. Fractions are truly all around us.
Fractions can actually be displayed in a bunch of different ways. They can be in a model, they can be on a number line, or they can actually be a part of a group. All right, I'm gonna show you a couple different models and let's see if you can name the fraction. Let's try this one.
This is a fraction model. You might notice that this is cut into pieces. When do you think you would use these models when solving a problem? There are 5 pieces there and there's 6 pieces in a whole. So our fraction is 5/6. There's 2 pieces in the picture, and there's 3 pieces in a whole, so our fraction is 2/3. You can also use a number line to show fractions. Let's look at a few number lines right now. Here is a fraction number line. What do you notice? What do you wonder? Between 0 and 1, it is cut into ninths. We're going to see how many jumps we need to make to get to the arrow. We make 6 jumps, so our fraction is 6/9. Look at a few more fraction number lines. What's similar about all these fraction number lines? What's different? All right, let's look at this one. Between 0 and 1, it is cut into 6ths. So now we're gonna see where the arrow is. We're going to make 2 jumps and we'll get to 2/6. You can also show fractions as a part of a group. Let's look at this picture right now. What fraction do you think this is showing? How do you think this represents a fraction? What do you notice? There's 3 lines. So in this group, 3 out of the entire group, which has 5, are limes. You could also look at it the other way. You could say 2 of the group is lemons, so 2 out of the 5 are lemons. Let's look at a few other parts of a group. What do you notice? What's the same? What's different? 3 of these chocolates in this chocolate box are squares. There's 6 chocolates in the box total, so our fraction is 3/6.
All right, let's try this one.
All right, so there's 4 chocolates total in this chocolate box, so our denominator is going to be 4. Now we're going to say that there's 3 square chocolates, so our fraction's going to be 3/4. If we were going to say the fraction of the circle chocolate, that would be 1/4.
Now that we've named a couple fractions together, let's see if you can do a couple on your own.
1/2. Five-eighths. You could say 4/6 of this group are limes, or if you did the lemons, 2/6 are lemons.
How'd you do? Did you get them all correct? Do you need other videos just like this one, or maybe things about mixed numbers, addition, subtraction? Make sure you check our other videos out on our YouTube channel, and make sure you like and subscribe so you don't miss a single video that we put out every single month.